Hi everyone, my name is Khaira Alam binti Khalid. My matric number is A166663. So I'm here to present about the do's and don'ts in conducting a meeting. There are 5 do's and 4 don'ts. So the first do is to prepare. For example, you can actually make an agenda, or you can assign your team members with several roles such as note taker or timekeeper. Also, you can actually state your objectives at the beginning of the meeting or your expectation that you would like to reach at the end of the meeting. So let's move on to the second do, which is do collaborate. You can actually encourage your teammates to talk or join in the meeting. For me, having a very good communication skills is very important in order to avoid any disagreement. For example, you can do brainstorming or asking suggestions or opinion. So for the third do, which is do actively participate. What you can do is to be mentally prepared for the meeting, just listen and ask appropriate questions. You can also ask for opinion or suggestions from your teammates for the meeting. And for most important thing is to silence your phone. The fourth do is very important if you are a leader, which is you should be able to foster positive teamwork. As a leader, you should be able to manage or control your teammates by not letting them have any fight or disagreement while having the meeting. Last but not least is to wrap it up on time. What you can do is to stick to your agenda and do not overtime. Some people may not like it, so yeah, better be careful. To complete very fast is you should outline or draft any suggestions or steps to be taken for the next meeting. Now we are doing the 4 don'ts of conducting the meeting. So the first one is don't let the meeting wander. Remember the agenda? You should stick to it and avoid any irrelevant topic about it. And most important thing is don't let your members wander too. You shouldn't use your power to dominate the meeting, but you can actually allow some of your teammates to lead the meeting as well. So for the third don't, which is don't be negative, you should give any positive feedbacks or comments towards your teammates, such as by praising them for their hard work. Your voice tone is very important. You shouldn't give any negative feedbacks or comments or judgmental comments towards your teammates as well as to discourage them. Lastly is don't forget visuals. You can prepare some handouts, visuals or videos to help your teammates to understand better what you're talking about. And also you can use some tools such as whiteboard to elaborate some facts and to let your teammates or hearers or viewers to understand better what you're talking about and what are you pointing out in the meeting as well. So that's all for me. Thank you.